Hi, in this video I'm going to show you how to code for keyboard events and how to make a simple move using ActionScript 3. Basically what we're going to do is make this little animation where I can move the symbol, the smiley face, around using the arrow keys on my keyboard. In this particular version of Animate, I'm using Animate CC 2018 on a Mac. For some reason the code doesn't work in the test, so if I ran this as a test, the code doesn't work. But if I export it, if I just shut this down, go to File, Export Movie, and save it as a SWIFT file, then the code does actually work. For some reason, in this particular version, I've tested the code out in the version before on a Windows computer, and it works just fine in the test, but in this particular one, it doesn't. It's probably just a little glitch. Anyway. So this animation basically just has one frame. That's the only frame that I've created with this symbol on the screen. The symbol is named Smiley. So this particular instance of this particular symbol is called Smiley. We'll actually refer to that in the code. I've made a second layer, which contains my ActionScript. So to get into the ActionScript, I'll right-click, click on the bottom option. You can't see it because I've cut the window off to a certain size. The bottom option says Actions. I'll click on that. And it'll load up my action script. And this is the script that will make this character move around like this. So if you remember before, the double slash means that this is just notes, so it's just to make it a little bit easier for me to read. So this first function is dealing with the movement of the character, looking at the keyboard and making it move. The first line here will get created once you start typing this out. So you don't need to type this out. You can if you want, but it will just automatically add it in for you. It's a function. So a function is a bit of code that can get called. It won't do anything until it's called, but it's a function that it's a bit of code that you can call and reuse throughout your programming. The name of this function is MoveSmiley. It can be called whatever you want, but in this particular case, I'm calling it MoveSmiley. It's an event. And it's a keyboard event. This event part of the code is a bit of information that will get passed on into the body of the text. So it's a keyboard event. This last little bit, the void, basically what that does is most functions will return something to Animate CC. This one doesn't, so I'm just telling that it doesn't. You don't have to have that there, but the program will look for something to, will keep looking to see if a bit of information will come back from that function, which will might slow it down, but you won't notice it in reality. So put it there or don't put it there, it doesn't really matter. Everything in the curly brackets is the code for this function. So this is the start of the function, this is the finish of the function, and then all of this is the code of that particular function. Basically, it's each of the possible keyboard events that it's looking for. So the first one, if this is true, so if there's an event with a key code where the keyboard equals left, so if that is true, it's going to move the smiley character, so that symbol that we have, 5 pixels to the right. And that's how we write that. In most codes, what you would be, in most programming languages, you probably go something like x equals x minus 5, but in Flash this is how that's scripted. So minus equals 5, that will take 5 away from x. What I did was just copy this bit of code and paste it in again and then changed it. So now when the keyboard equals right, so you're pushing on right, smiley equals x plus 5. So you're moving the smiley character on the x-axis, so the horizontal axis. Everything in the if statement is within these curly brackets, just like the function. So if this is true, if this line of text is true, it's going to run what's in between the curly brackets. So this one line of text moving the smiley to the left. If what happens here is true, it'll run this bit of code, which will move it to the right. And then basically I copied and pasted that 2 more times for up and down. Same idea, except now we're looking at the y-axis. If you're pushing up, you're taking 5 away. If you're pushing down, you're adding 5. So this is the function that moves it around. For it to actually work, we need to call that function. So that's what this little bit of code is here. So this is adding something to the stage, so the main part of the animation. It's adding an event listener, so it's waiting for something to happen. It's a keyboard event, so it's waiting for something to have happen to the keyboard, and it's waiting for a key to be pressed, basically any key. If any key gets pressed, what it will do is it'll run this bit of code, and this bit of code will check whether it's up, down, left, or right. So if it's any other key, it will still run this bit of code, but nothing will happen because it's none of those keys. And that's how you make a keyboard event, which will make this little animation here. The end.